Welcome to the editing game.
Every editor, every creator starts here. Confused, frustrated, inspired by others, but unsure how to bridge the gap. Because editing is like a game, there's levels to it. Each one has its own boss fights, hidden power-ups and shortcuts. And in this video I'm gonna walk you through each one, from beginner to master, and show you exactly what to do to keep leveling up. Level 1, beginner. When you first start, everything feels overwhelming. You open the app and you see all these features and buttons that you have no clue how to use. It's very annoying, but normal. This is the tutorial level, where your job is just to learn the basic tools of the software. I would recommend Premiere or DaVinci, but you can use whatever you like. Now learn the basic tools of the software you chose. Just look it up, there are plenty of tutorials teaching you the basics. Try to make one short edit every day. Even if it sucks, staying consistent for 14 days will make you a much better editor. Now once you start making the edits, you will realize how much there is actually to learn. And you will be met with the enemies that stay with you for the entire journey. It's the thoughts of quitting. These guys are across all levels. You cannot avoid them, but they are easily defeated if you have this tool. And this one tool is finding your why. For me, the why was creating everything that's in my mind with editing. I can do literally anything. And it's one of the only activities that really gets me into the flow, fully zoned in. Of course, money was a thing as well. I didn't want to be the broke artist stereotype. So I chose editing because I knew it had real earning potential and it was also the best way I could express myself. And this will be an actionable step for you to do. Get a piece of paper and journal about it. Ask yourself, why am I doing this? Am I doing it for the money? Are you passionate about it? And why are you passionate about it? This is a very important thing to do because your why will help you go through the hard times. The biggest challenge you will ever face is the fight with your self-judgment. The best advice I can give you right now to beat up self-judgment is to understand that you're not supposed to do everything perfect. You are just supposed to start and learn the software. So just take action, avoid the enemy. He will try to get you to compare yourself and try to stress you to take your focus away from growing. But you have to not pay attention to him. Don't let be down if the progress is slow. It will be worth it because you're working for something greater. Step 2, advanced. Okay, you survived and things are starting to click. You know the software, you can trim sequences, you can add stuff. This level will be about building and keeping your momentum. Now, there are two things that can prevent you from beating this stage. It's complacency and opportunity cost. And a simple shift in your mindset will help you get past both of them. To help you understand, I'm gonna tell you my story of the things I had to say no to in order to move on to the next stage. So I first got into editing because I wanted to make music videos. I was just doing it for fun and that was the thing that kept me going. Then I wanted to start making money. So I had to monetize my passion and I started to make short form videos. I was always requested fast deliveries and quick edits, so I had to rush things, make them worse and faster. I was just sticking to my current level, I didn't learn anything from doing those videos. In other words, I made a deal with the opportunity cost. And deals go both ways. He gave me money and I gave him time. Time I could have used to improve my skills and learn new things, so I could learn to make better videos. Luckily, I realized this and I needed to make a choice. Keep doing the same thing, keep the stable income and not grow as much, or sacrifice money for growth. For me, the choice was clear, and that was one of the best decisions I ever made. I had finally time to improve my skills, and not long after, I got the opportunity to work on long form videos. This was a job that kept my fire going. It was giving me the ability to become better and enjoy it. I started to spend hours on videos, not because I had to, because I wanted to. And oddly enough, I was still making good money. This is why I'm telling you to find your love for editing and to make sure you find an environment that will help you achieve that. So I'm giving you permission to lock in and make the best stuff that you possibly can make. Impress yourself and at the same time impress your clients. But to be totally transparent with you, at this stage your edits are probably not that good. It takes a lot of time to learn this skill. But here are the technical stuff you should learn at this stage in order to level up. Learn how to use key shortcuts. Learn how to add zoom ins with adjustment layers. Use transform with motion blur. Learn to find the balance in the audio between voice and music, and basic animation skills. Honestly, if you are not happy with your edits right now, that's good. It means you're improving your taste faster than your skills. You're on the right path. You're fired up and the goal isn't to be perfect. It's to fall in love with editing. Level 3. Intermediate. This level is where you start to feel your edits. You're not just editing anymore, you're in the flow. And this is where your style starts to emerge. But you may ask yourself, how do I find my style? To do this, you need to collect cool inspiration. For example, every time you see a clean animation, a cool layout, or a smart use of color, you should save it. This will help you create your eye for design, so you can then create more original work. And you shouldn't always look for designs. Watch great movies that people always talk about. Pay attention on how they made you feel. Why do people like it so much? And how they made the shots look so good. Take note of those as you will need them later. As you can tell by now, you don't find your style by trying to create something original. Originality doesn't mean you have to create something new from scratch that no one has ever created. Originality means using the inspiration you found to build something new. Your style comes from repetition, from studying what you love, copying, remixing, until suddenly it starts to feel like you. So for now, stop worrying about being different. Just make what you enjoy, the rest will follow. But finding what you like is the easy part, because now that you're starting to find out that you have the potential to make something great, your self-judgment will creep again. But this time, he'll be more powerful and be named overthinking. He will try to put you down by telling you your work is not good enough, that you should make everything perfect before releasing it or giving it to your client. But here's what you need to do. Exactly the opposite of what he says, but still listen to him. If he says your work is bad, ask yourself, is it actually bad or is it just an insecurity of mine? You will notice as you keep doing this that you will break him. He will no longer affect you, because you will know when something is good enough. Sure, you can always make it better, but there's a point in all projects when you are not learning anything new from focusing on every single detail. So here are your tasks for this level. First, build your inspiration board. Save stuff from Pinterest, Twitter, YouTube, or the cinema, and start learning more advanced stuff that you want to learn, and I would recommend you to start learning After Effects. Personally, I avoided After Effects for months. I always tried to do everything in Premiere, and that slowed me down a lot. The moment I committed to After Effects, it was hard. So many panels, so many effects, but within 30 days, my edits looked like they leveled up 2 years. Don't be like me, don't be afraid to learn a new app if you need it. And anyway, once you get used to it a little bit, you'll find it easy to use. You don't need to become a master now, just become familiar to it. Use the same steps that you use for Premiere. Also, if you want to learn how I made all these retro-style pixel animations inside this video, I have made a 5-part course, going through everything, from how to create assets, how to animate them, how to add the right sound effects, and a live breakdown of me editing a scene from this video. Also, I made a pack with all the assets I used in this video. If you are interested in learning more about it, I left a link in the description. Now let's get back to level 4. Level 4, professional. This level is no longer about mastering tools, it's about mastering yourself. At first, you feel sharp, and the things you create finally start to reflect your taste. But then, you hit a wall. You make something that looks good, but feels off. So you try again, and again, and somehow it still doesn't feel like a good video. Then it hits you. You're no longer editing from reference, you're creating from your mind. And at this stage, the question shifts. It's not, is it cool? It's, does this serve the story? Does this help the viewer understand the world I'm building? This level teaches you something critical. Your edits have to be planned. You have to see them before you build them. At this stage, your animation will start to look better and be the quality of the ones on your own reference board. But to take things to the next level, you won't stop here. You will need to start using the design skills you've learned so far. People at this stage need to learn color, composition, and design consistency. Here's my checklist I developed to make sure all my animations look amazing. Make sure the colors are complementary. You can use Adobe Color to help you with this. Make sure the composition is balanced. Look at the frame from far away, and if both sides have the same weight, it means the composition is balanced. Or if it's not balanced, make sure it is, because you intended it to be that way. And 3, do all my animations feel cohesive with each other? Is the color theme roughly the same? Are they created in the same style? If you answer all these questions, you will have a good starting point. Here are my top 5 effects in After Effects in order to make your stuff look good. Vignette, Posterize, Shadow Studio 3, Noise, and Deep Glow 2. All of these work, trust me. So this level where you have to grind out animation, it can get quite frustrating. Because even when your skills are sharp, your mind can still burn out. And this is the toughest boss of them all. Think of it like a stamina bar. Every time you make something meaningful, every time you remember where you started, every time you imagine the kind of editor you want to become, you refill that bar. And at this stage you realize, your work is actually good, true to you. And this is what mastery starts to feel like. You know all the tools. You can do anything that's in your head. Your taste and skills are finally aligned. Here, you start to realize that it's not enough to make things look good. Now you should ask, how can I make something unique? Something that only I could have made. You watch other people's content and wonder, how can I make my viewers feel the same in my videos? This is where you start thinking like a director, not just an editor. This is also the most peaceful level, because for the first time you're free and you are proud of what you created. Don't get me wrong, it's still quite hard in different ways. Your mind will always be filled with thoughts and ideas. Should I be more productive? What's stopping me from becoming better? What am I missing? Now you realize how much potential you have and you're afraid of wasting it. You will have more opportunities than ever and you will have to say no to everything that doesn't align with you. You have to remember what got you here. It's the love for editing. If you lose that, you lose the game. But to take those things aside, it's ultimately the most fun stage to be in. You don't have to think about the technical stuff, you just focus on creating. And all the hours you spend grinding are 100% worth it. This level never ends, there's always more to explore. But that's the beauty of editing. I think there's so much room to grow, always. And for me it just feels like I'm starting again now. I would love to hear your experience with editing in the comments. We are together in all of this, creators, editors, artists, trying to get better, trying to make something amazing. Anyways, I really hope you enjoyed this video and I will see you next time.